letter lay on Gugnidi's desk. The letter was addressed to Don Punchinello, but Vinny had never had the nerve to finish it.
Jack's gone voodoo. Just the other night, he shot Dino because he wanted to see what his brains looked like splattered on the wall. He's a freaking mad dog. We're running out of men and business fast.
Gugnidi had been living in mortal fear of his boss. Jack Lupino was a psycho. Vinny Gugnidi was running scared. He could run, but with a bullet in his stomach like a broken bottle of Tabasco, he was quickly running out of time. He knew where his boss was, and I wanted to square things up with Jack Lupino. Gugnidi would be moving fast. I don't know about angels, but it's fear that gives men wings. Gugnidi hitched a ride. To catch him, I'd have to follow his lead. This was my second train ride of the night. The way it started didn't promise anything better than the last one. Freezing wind tearing at my face like sandpaper and razors, ice hard and slick under my hands and feet. Somewhere in the background, the wail of sirens, the city howling after me. New York sped by and fast forward, dark rooftop water towers and a dead forest of antennas and chimneys, all a blur. When the train he was riding slowed down, Gugnidi made his move.